Gold star, take one.
You know, I was wondering, you know, if you could keep on, because the force, it's got a lot of power, and it makes me feel like, it makes me feel like...
So that's enough of that song, since it's an 8-minute track. What I have here today is my electronic setup. Typically all my videos are of my acoustic kits, and these are always set at the side, so I really don't use them as my main kit standalone. I'm always using them in conjunction with the acoustic kit. But for today's video, I thought, let's just use these as a standalone drum set. Up on top, what I do have is my Roland SPDS, and this is a sampling unit, and what I do here is I can record samples, I could record loops, so loop phrasing,
yeah.
So stuff like that, and it's velocity sensitive, so the lighter I hit it,
yeah,
lower pitch, really strike it. Plenty of percussion, which I was just using. So for the Michael stuff, I have all the percussion. The second unit is my Roland SPD-11. This has been my workhorse for over 20 years now. The kit that I was using was a TR-909 sound. So the top unit has 9 surfaces to work with. You can see it's a smaller unit. I like using the middle unit as the main one, only because it's bigger. It has more real estate to work with. And this has 8 surfaces. So essentially I have 17 surfaces, and I could stack sounds. So realistically I have 34 sounds up at once. You don't just have to have... percussion, I could have, so I have that type of stuff, and I could stack sounds as well, so instead of just having single notes, I could put chords. The third unit I have is my old Yamaha DTX module, and what I use for this is if I'm connecting my acoustic triggers to my kit, I could have whatever, piano chords if I choose to do that. So some of my videos, if you're hearing loops being played, typically it's from my Yamaha kit. And it's a nice way to have a lot of creativity. You're only limited by your imagination, what you could do with this stuff. And that's about it. Thank you very much for watching.